Welcome back, I'm Laure, and today we are going to be talking about complex numbers in physics. Now, if you never studied math, you may have come across complex numbers before. But if you haven't, don't worry, we are going to start from the very basics. First of all, let's talk about what a number is. A number is just a way of representing a quantity. It could be something like 3, 5, or 8. And we use numbers all the time in our daily lives, to count things, to measure things, and even to make calculations. We use positive integers to count things like a number of people. We use fractions like 3 over 5 to count parts of a thing. For example, we could see that 3 over 5 of a crowd of 5 people equals 3 people. We use negative numbers too. They don't make sense to count things like people since we cannot have negative people. But you can have negative money in your bank account, for example. And sometimes we need special numbers to do mathematics operations that are not possible with the other numbers. And this is where complex numbers come in. A complex number is a number that has two parts, a real part and an imaginary part. The real part is just a regular number like 3 or 5, but the imaginary part is a little bit different. The imaginary part of a complex number is represented by the letter I, and this letter represents the square root of minus 1. Now you may be wondering why we would need such a strange number. Well, it turns out that the square root of minus 1 is incredibly useful in physics. As an example, complex numbers are incredibly useful in electricity and electronics. When we work with alternating voltage that we call AC voltage, the electricity has an amount of energy that we call a potential on a phase that describes the wave of the flow of electricity. These two values, the potential and the phase, are linked to each other, so it is awkward to work with each separately. Complex numbers allow us to represent both together with one special number which we can convert back to a voltage and a phase when we want to. And here's how we represent a complex number. Suppose we want to calculate the speed of an object moving in a circle. In order to do this, we can use something called the polar coordinate system to make our life easier. We represent the position of an object using two numbers, the distance from the center of the circle and the angle that the object is at. Since the distance from the center remains the same at all times, it becomes easier to do mathematical operations. Well, we represent complex numbers in the same way, with a distance from the center and an angle on something that we call a polar plane. The polar plane is just a two-dimensional plane like other planes, except that it helps us humans visualize complex numbers. And it is used in Fourier transform, but I'm not going to scare you with this. What you can do is give this video a like, as it helps me a lot, and hitting the like button is a lot easier than using Fourier transforms. On the complex plane, the real part of a complex number is represented by the horizontal axis, and the imaginary part is represented by the vertical axis. So for example, if we have a complex number with a real part of 3 and an imaginary part of 4, it will be represented by the point 3,4 on the complex plane. Now, we want to represent a complex number in polar form. We use something called an angle and a magnitude. The angle is just the angle that the complex number makes with the horizontal axis on the complex plane. And the magnitude is the distance of the complex number from the origin of the complex plane. As we discussed with electricity, complex numbers are also used in other areas of physics, such as computer science, magnetism, and even quantum mechanics. In fact, many of the equations that we use in physics have complex numbers in them. And that's why it's so important for physicists to understand complex numbers. They may seem strange at first, but they are actually incredibly useful in helping us understand the world around us. So if you are interested in physics, I hope this video was useful. And if you'd like to know more, please check out another one of my videos or subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.